Okay, YouTubers, today I'm gonna show you some of my South African Defence Force collections, starting off with this M87 Kevlar helmet. It replaced the 1963 helmet that was a copy of the 1951 French helmet. And I'm now talking about the steel helmet. Okay, so this one has a cover. Here, let me just take off the cover. It has a little bit of a dent there, but the rest is in perfect conditions. This is the M87, as I said, with its nutria colored cover here. South Africa was one of the first colored countries to go with a Kevlar helmet. This is the neutral color helmet that matches the terrain of South Africa with the nutria cover over here. As I said, I hope I'm saying the color right. I don't really know how to say that. But anyhow, this is actually a pretty sweet dome protected helmet, as you can see. It's really nice. Okay, so this is a chin strap. You just push down on here, it's kind of like a seatbelt thingy. It has a 3-point chin strap, kind of like most European helmets do and still have, so it's a little bit better. It has a nice comfortable chin. Here is the chin strap cup. It's like a cup shape. It's really big with leather padding, as you can see, so it's nice and comfortable. You also got this little leather flap over here to protect you from your face from this buckle over here, so that is kind of neat. I actually like this this really a lot. It's made out of heavy duty canvas. This all is canvas, not nylon. There is foam in the back over here, also foam padding there in the top of the helmet. It's really comfy, just to make it a little bit easier for the soldier to wear this thing. Then you got the leather sweatband that's all around here. That is in really good shape, actually. As you can see, it's not weird or anything like that. Most people don't know this, well, I didn't know this, but this part back here is nylon, this over here. So if you just turn it around, I'm quickly gonna try and show you, you can actually adjust the height of the helmet, and I did not know this. Plus, you can strap it loose over there, or just adjust the height of this helmet to your preference. It was actually 13 years ahead. Time is first made ahead. Some of its with the pioneers in a similar one F1380s after ADM. There was 7. They were used up late 30s. These were until the when they lined with other lines. In the start of the design, it was in from 1880 service, you can see 1977, as you but let me just show 8 year old it's in the way. It looks like a 9, but from I can assure you that's a 1987. Here to the late 19s when they replaced the steel helmets. Yes, so this Kevlar helmets replaces the steel helmets. I'm also gonna do a video on the steel helmets because I kind of also have one. Okay, so these helmets were made by a company called South Africa Puff Helmet Industry, and it actually has a tag inside where I've already shown you that verifies that the SAPHI. So yes, with the 1987 in there. Yes, so that is all the details on this tag. So yes, this is the SADF M87 helmet. So yes, please like and subscribe if you want to see more of my other collections.
Ja, kom. Wat?